see you both. Sorry, I just got my consent from Jamina to record here. So let me go ahead and share my screen. But as mentioned, this is truly a conversation. Andy and I, if you have questions, if you want to talk about what this looks like specifically for your school, your district, your classroom, that's what we're here for today. So we'll go ahead and dive right in. And if at any point in time you have questions and want to interrupt, please pause us and we're happy to have that conversation. I'll quickly introduce myself. I am Jessica Golden. As you heard, I am based in Phoenix, Arizona. Prior to my time at EVERFI, I was a middle school science teacher, which hence the melting shoes. And I have been working with EVERFI now for almost 7 years, and I've transitioned to a district director. So my role is really to work with our largest school districts in the Southwest United States to think about placement of our programs, course alignment, and help to coordinate and set up those teacher trainings to be able to scale our resources within your districts. Then I get to work alongside Andy, and I'll let Andy introduce herself.
Hello, my name is Andy. I'm a senior schools manager with EVERFI. I actually just had my 4-year anniversary with EVERFI a few days ago. Prior to working for EVERFI, I worked as an English as a second language teacher and then a 6th grade and 2nd grade teacher. So my passion for education has been around for quite a while. As a senior schools manager, I work directly with teachers and students. So I help teachers get started with EVERFI, and I'm able to be their contact person for all things EVERFI, whether that's questions about our course information, tech support that they may need, or implementation strategies. So I really enjoy working directly with teachers and being able to answer all those questions for them.
So today in our time, we'll really dive into introductions, which we just did. Then we'll spend some time looking at the EVERFI overview, talking about specifically financial literacy and financial capability. Why do we need it? And what are some of the resources, followed by next steps? We have a pretty small group today. So again, if you have other topics you want to think about specific for your school or district site, we're happy to dive in and kind of take it down that track to make sure that you're getting what you need from this conversation today. So for many of you, EVERFI might be a new company and organization for you. So we're an education technology company focused on preparing students for what's to come after high school and thinking about the whole child. We offer everything, as you imagine, from financial literacy to social emotional learning to college and career readiness courses and STEM preparedness. So as we're thinking about these programs, all of them are funded and available to you at no cost, thanks to local and national partners that are funding these. So our districts have full access to these resources with unlimited licenses because of these organizations funding the programs and making sure that they're consistently updated to match new standards, to match new things. We know banking is changing regularly. So making sure the content is current and relatable to our students. So this means all of the digital curriculum is provided at no cost. As mentioned, unlimited student licenses for all of our sites. And then you get our local dedicated implementation team, which is Andy and myself really working alongside you. So again, we know some of the biggest challenges with districts is everyone is managing a lot. Teachers are also managing a lot every day. And we don't want this to be something else on your plate, but really looking at us as partners to help you with integration and planning what the rollout can look like for your schools and districts. And we'll really be that main point of contact. So if you do decide as a school admin, as a district admin, or even as a teacher that you wanna share this, we're here to provide that support and to make sure that it's easy as possible. We also provide district alignment. So if you are thinking about how might this fit into my course curriculum, Andy and I collaborate regularly to think about what's that placement, looking at your district curriculum maps and showing here's exactly where the different resources can fit into the content you already have. Because everything we do is supplemental. We know that you have incredible resources you're already sharing with your students and educators. We're here to help supplement and support with that. And then finally, each year we offer what we call our annual impact report. So in this annual impact report, it includes student knowledge gains, attitudinal changes, and giving you a really idea of what the reach and breadth of our programs are within your district. So these are really customized specifically to each school district, giving you that data and information to drive your decisions on how these programs are impacting your students. So again, all of these always free. All of the programs include assessments and reporting that are automatically graded. You have local support. And in addition to those engaging digital lessons, we have full supplemental offline lessons, extension guides, discussion tools, everything educators need to really implement these with fidelity and confidence. Any initial questions about EVERFI, how we function, what the partnership model looks like?
Not for me.
Perfect. I see thumbs up. All right. I will quickly jump into this and then I'm going to hand it over to Andy to talk through our specific program. So this is what we call our menu of resources. So as this is a menu, I also like to say our resources are like a buffet. You can pick and choose what programs best fit the needs of your students, even within these courses, choosing specific lessons that align to your content. Today, we're really going to be leaning into this far left column of financial education. So looking at the resources available for elementary through high school, focusing on financial capability. But I did want to highlight the other programs we have available. So as many of you might be teaching different content areas, might be overseeing many content areas, do want to let you know that these other resources are available to your schools and districts at no cost as well. So a lot of times we might see, in addition with financial education, leaning into some of this STEM and career readiness, maybe thinking about career exploration, resources available here as well. All right. So we'll jump into each of these. This is a quick highlight of the financial education at every stage. We have actually really built out and redid our elementary financial literacy, our middle school financial literacy. And then here you're gonna see, we have a full high school financial literacy suite. We know that this is when our students are getting their first jobs. They're thinking about financing higher education. They're thinking about investing. Maybe this year more than ever, students are looking at, with Robinhood and other things coming out and what happened with GameStop, a lot of interest in investing. So wanting to make sure that we really demystify some of these concepts and make it approachable for all learners, no matter what level they're coming in at, so that they are really leveling the playing field and all students have that baseline information about these core concepts. So financial capability, I'll hand it over to Andy.
Perfect, so starting with Vault, which is our elementary level financial literacy course. All of the programs that we're about to show you have sort of the same format of slides. So make sure you look on the left side for the grade level recommendation, and then the total lessons will give you an idea of how long each course is. So something I want to say about the grade level recommendations is that this is just a recommendation and it's based on the reading level that the course was designed with. So Vault's Understanding Money aligns best with fourth through sixth grade, but that doesn't mean that a third or seventh grade class couldn't use it if their teacher thought that it was best fit for them based on the reading level. We've certainly had cases where teachers went outside of that recommendation because I always say that teachers know their students best, and that's an example of that. You can see the different standard alignments there on the left too. I won't go and read off all of those, but this course typically fits best just in a regular classroom or in econ, math, guidance, or CTE. And Vault is a fun sort of gamified program that exposes elementary students to financial literacy. So they're getting really important definitions that they may not have heard in their math class before that just show them not only the definition of financial literacy, but it walks them through financial decision-making, what a budget is, needs versus wants. And all the while that they're going through these different modules within the lesson, they're put into fun scenarios where, like I said, it's sort of gamified and they get to practice what money decisions they would be making for themselves. And then we'll move forward.
Andy, oftentimes when we're on these, people are like, I want to see it. I want to get a feel for it. So
perfect.
I did pull up a sneak peek to get an idea. Students are being introduced to a fun storyline in this mystical world where they're jumping around, and here they're helping Jet Turbo. He needs to fix his scooter. And so figuring out how to set a budget, how to make sure that you're doing smart spending. So giving students a storyline, to build off and then build, help them start solving problems. So everything in our resources for financial literacy, we try to make it that scenario-based learning. So putting students in a real life situation that they might experience and giving them a safe place to play it out. But you'll notice the look and feel of this is gonna be very different than the look and feel of our high school resources.
So colorful and fun. Students love when they sign in. They get really excited that they get to play a game that's about this.
This slide here is a snapshot of what it looks like for an impact report. So as mentioned, every year we provide an impact report in the summer that highlights the student learning objectives, the reach of your program. So this is giving an idea of students from their pre-assessment scores to their post-assessment and being able to see those knowledge gains. So this is actually from a California specific impact report. So you'll see that students for income and careers jump from a 62% pre-assessment score all the way up to an 88%. And we also see a huge jump here with making plans with money, identifying needs versus wants, starting at a 61% to an 84%. So this is the kind of data that you can expect to see for your specific district for each of the resources we'll talk about today.
Perfect. And then the next financial literacy program that we have is going to be one level up for middle schoolers, the grade level recommendation, sixth through eighth grade. Seven lessons total that are each around 20 to 25 minutes. And this might be my favorite of our financial literacy courses. Students get to play the mayor of a town, and the town's happiness is based on their financial decisions. So, you know, one of the examples is there's a student who's redecorating his room, and he has to kind of figure out the difference between wants and needs when it comes to making a comfortable room for himself. So not only are they learning about needs and wants, but they get to choose something that fits their personality and their style preferences. And so it's just a really fun, interactive way for students to get to make financial literacy decisions on their own. We like to think of this, you know, the different courses that are built for financial literacy as a transition from financial literacy to financial capability. So as they're working through these decision-making skills, they're getting more comfortable with making financial decisions for their own or on their own. And then you'll see some of those topics below that are really important, being able to goal set, budgeting and understanding opportunity costs, saving versus investing, and then risk versus return. So these are just really great concepts that students are building into their decision-making. And it's just really great. It's a little bit less gamified than the last one. You'll see with the different screenshots that we look at, they get a little bit more mature as they move on. And so this one is still fun and game-like, but it's a little bit more built for middle schoolers as opposed to elementary schoolers.
And so one of the things we did a research study last year of 20,000 students that took our Future Smart course. And on average, students had a 90% knowledge gain from their pre to post assessment. So really we wanted to come in and look, when we're hitting that middle school, this is our students are starting to have a stronger awareness of money. They're seeing spending habits in their home. Wanted to really take and analyze the data from the teachers in both the control group and in the treatment group to really determine how is this program impacting. So 90% of students saw a meaningful increase in knowledge gain after taking the course, and 50% of students saw an increase of 20 points or more on their knowledge gain. So really making huge significant jumps from what they knew before and their initial understanding to where they're at now. But we wanted to take this a step further, as this was just a one-year study. We are constantly hearing from our schools, our districts, Catalina and the County Office of Ed, State Ed, how do we really see a longitudinal study of how financial literacy is impacting our students? So this year we are launching a longitudinal study for students, for families that have students in seventh or eighth grade. And really we're asking them to commit to working with us for the next 4 years. So I provided some information up here. Our goal is really to measure what are their financial behaviors, plans, academic outcomes, all related if they are getting consistent financial education all 4 years. So in this, it is a family sign up. So families are committing, they'll get access to our full financial education suite. Parents and guardians will also get access to our adult financial education. So really making this a family and community effort on how we can increase financial capability. There's also some nice perks for our families if they sign up, some incentives. I do believe there's a $500 annual incentive for having their families sign up, participate in this. So I will go ahead and chat this in to everyone. If you do want to take a look, if this is something that you think your families would be interested in, if they have rising seventh or eighth graders, I will send that over to you. But totally option. Flexible, not a requirement. But what is great is if you have individuals from your district signing up for this or from your county or school site, we can pull that data into an aggregate data to see what does this look like for your community so that you can be a part of seeing that data for the longitudinal study. Before we jump on, it's such a small group. Any questions before I know that was a big piece there before we jump into our high school resources. Great, okay. Andy, I'll pass it back to you.
All right, I have to apologize. There's construction happening on my street, of course, as we're doing this. You too? Okay, great. Glad we're in that together. So for this course, this is called EVERFI Financial Literacy, and this is the most information dense course. It's, I think, our longest course total. So it's 7 lessons. Each of them are about 20 to 30 minutes each. So it's still, not so much that students can't handle it. It really is meant to be done maybe once, one module per day so that they are digesting as much as they can as they go through it. But when students take this course, they're really diving into banking basics with some exposure to online banking as well. It talks about income and employment, what it means to have a salary, budgeting, consumer skills so that they understand how to be a responsible consumer, and then managing credit and debt. So it gives them some really good, again, realistic life scenarios where they get to interact and make that decision for themselves based on what they've learned for all things financial literacy. There's a lot of opportunities for self-reflection as well. And yeah, it just exposes them to different scenarios that they will come in contact with, both now during their high school career or once they graduate and either go off to college or start a career in the real world.
Yeah, so here's a quick peek of what this program looks like. So already getting pretty different look and feel than what we saw for Vault in our elementary program. So students are able to select the module from down below. They're able to see their progress as they are going through it, see their quiz score, what did they receive, and even to be able to see the lesson length for each of these. So whenever students start, it'll kick them into giving them some background knowledge, what objectives
are they- In this module, you will reflect on how you-
Giving them the objectives for the lesson, but you'll notice a really different look and feel, helping them understand what it is that they're going to achieve and then pushing them right into that pre-assessment. So similarly to Vault, we also offer those knowledge gains here. So again, seeing really significant jumps. So students starting at 56% for banking basics, jumping all the way to an 81% in California. You also see credit and debt, 59% all the way up to an 83%. So we even know as adults, many may not be confident or know what a credit score is. How do you improve your credit score? So really laying that foundation for our students from the get-go so that they can make smart financial decisions for themselves as they head off into the real world.
All right, when we look at venture and entrepreneurial expedition, this course is designed for upper middle school or lower high school. And we like to think of this as much more project-based learning. So students are, again, using their financial literacy and turning it into financial capability by building a business strategy for a food truck. So they get to make all the important decisions, what food they're selling, their marketing strategy. And then again, like the theme that you've heard throughout all these courses, there's a lot of true to life scenarios where they get to sort of make those high end decisions on how they would react, where they would invest money in different places. And then at the end, they get to share this business pitch. And we've seen teachers do it like a Shark Tank style where they'll have other teachers come in and sort of evaluate the plans that they've come up with. But this course is a really great opportunity for students to use their creativity when it comes to financial literacy. Yeah, it's a great fit for, as you can see there, finance, econ, social studies, business, and CTE as just a few examples there. Marketplaces, this is a big focus on investing. So like Jessica mentioned earlier, a lot of students had so much, they were just really interested in stocks after the GameStop thing all happened. And so this gives them sort of a good reference to some of that. And it talks about how to invest your money and what makes the most sense for different phases of your life. And it just helps them feel comfortable with investing. So it doesn't feel like something that's so far away or out of reach, makes them feel comfortable with making those decisions. So it talks about the financial market and exchanges, the government's role in the economy, which is something that they might not have been exposed to even in their econ classes quite yet, or growing a company through financing and even building an investment portfolio.
I said this one too, with when thinking about growing a company through financing, if students start with venture and they're like thinking about starting their own business, learning what it means to be an entrepreneur, here's where they can come in and talk about what does it mean to take a business from a private company all the way to IPO, and really helping to, I think this can be complicated as an adult. I still haven't fully wrapped my mind around this. My husband has constant conversations with me and I think it's one ear off the other. So this program really helps to make it achievable and understandable for all of our different learners. So I should probably go back through it as I think the way.
I always say that when I talk about joining EVERFI, I took, you know, when you start this job, you take all the courses and I took EVERFI financial literacy before I bought my first home. And I am so happy I did. It really helps me, you know, just gain an understanding about, even just buying a house and having that knowledge. It was really helpful. So moving on, Money Moves is about modern banking and identity protection. So this is something that's really important for students to know, if especially after they are learning about, you know, how to be financially independent or just to have an idea of financial literacy in general. They're going to be interested in starting their own account. Some of them have had their own accounts for a while. We know that every student, there's just a wide range of comfort when it comes to online banking and having their own account. So this gives them a really good base level for how to protect your identity, how to use online banking safely, and how to use it in a smart way so that it's helping you and helping you prepare for your future. So it talks about introductory financial concepts. It talks about modern digital banking. So as a lot of them know, you're accessing this through your phone or through your computer, and that does jeopardize the safety sometimes of passwords and things like that. So it talks to them about being safe in that sense by discussing identity theft, fraud protection, and then peer-to-peer transactions like apps like Venmo. You know, if for some reason you accidentally are sending a lot of money to a certain person, it's out of your hands. It's not something that you can just get back right away. And so sort of taking the time to discuss that with them and putting that information in their hands so they understand some of the ramifications for their actions with online banking. All right, and then Pathways is specifically focused to financing higher education. Students who take EVERFI financial literacy will get a small window into this topic, but we found that so many teachers were really eager to focus on financing higher education. And so we created an entire course focused on just that. You know, depending on a student's family background, their parents may not have had any past experience with the FAFSA or college applications or anything like that. And so this walks them through those basics and just makes it much more manageable for them. So they don't, you know, they're not feeling stuck or like they don't know where to even begin. So again, scenario-based narrative where students are, they actually get a practice filling out different forms. They get to see what the different components of those forms mean and what, you know, what they're actually signing up for. So it helps them kind of learn through problem solving by giving them the exposure to those different forms and things. And then some of the topics that it covers, return on investment, so why it's worth it to finance higher education, understanding financial aid and how it can be helpful. And on the flip side, how it can be dangerous if you don't look pretty far into the type of interest loans that you might be taking out, things like that. Student loan basics, budgeting for your loans, so how to make it more understandable for them when it comes to actually paying back those really high numbers that they might be seeing, and then repaying loans responsibly.
So we've gone through quite a bit and we're going to jump to the last one, but as a friendly reminder, you can pick and choose from these lessons. So if there are specific lessons that you think my students really need that specific lesson, there's flexibility and autonomy in being able to select those. So there's never a requirement that you have to go through all five lessons for, you know, over an hour of content. If you're finding that, hey, we just really want to go through return on investment, make sure students understand maybe their sophomore year as they're thinking about applications next year, helping them to think about that. Then the following year, if it's going through understanding financial aid, et cetera, you have the autonomy to really break this down to fit the needs of your students in your district.
And teachers also have the ability to make that decision as they go. So let's say they're a math teacher or econ teacher, and they're finding that their students just aren't grasping one concept. They can, you know, look for the module that fits best to that concept and just use that module. And that's also where my position as a schools manager comes in. If they're feeling stuck and want to figure out the best way to use EVERFI as a supplemental resource, then I can make those recommendations and help figure out a way for them to implement it comfortably into their scope and sequence. All right, and then the last course we're going to be reviewing today is healthcare literacy. This is a really, really exciting new course that we are going to be releasing before the end of July. So this is a brand new one. You may be hearing more about programs that EVERFI releases based on teacher requests, which is something we pride ourselves on. We're not releasing hundreds of courses a year. We're very purposeful with what we create and what we release. And healthcare literacy is so needed for adults, including myself. But it's something that we are passionate about students learning in high school or before, you know, they're graduating and going into the real world. So this is designed for high school students, four lessons that are about 15 minutes each. So it really is a quick course that students will be able to go through, provided in both English and Spanish. And as I've mentioned with, I think every single one of the courses now, it's a scenario-based narrative. So they're going to be able to have those interactive scenarios where they get to make decisions for themselves and really learn through problem solving. So the three main topics that will be discussed are healthcare coverage, seeking care, and paying for care. We're hoping that by, you know, giving this information to students, it will help students not either waste money by paying for something that they didn't realize was covered, or, you know, just make this whole, you know, being able to use healthcare just a much more comfortable, easy process for everyone. So if you can't tell, I'm very excited about this course.
I love it, Andy. I'm also really excited, you know, especially after the last year with the pandemic. This is really top of mind for a lot of our students, whether they're hearing from their families, their communities, what's going on, making sure that this is approachable. I think even as adults, that healthcare literacy can be complicated. What's the right type of health coverage for me? And making sure that we're giving students that comfort so they're seeking care when they need care. A lot of, you know, different families and communities based on different socioeconomic status may wait to get care. So helping students to understand their options and resources. So moving forward, as a reminder, all of our programs have real-time pre- and post-assessment knowledge gains that go directly to teacher dashboards. So teachers are able to monitor student progress and success as they are going through these different lessons right in their reports tab on the teacher dashboard. In addition, we also have lesson tools and supplemental resources. So within each of our within each of our resources, you can click resources And this is where you're going to find all the different tools and information to expand on these topics. So here you're going to see additional lesson plans, assessment keys, planning resources, including course outline, curriculum guides. All of this is done for you to make implementation as easy as possible for educators. We also have those extension activities and then scholarships. So anytime that we're releasing new programs, you will be the first to know about it. You'll get an update when you're in our system, but you'll also have access to scholarships. So every year we're offering a variety of different scholarships, oftentimes through a 529 scholarship plan. So certainly be on the lookout for those. You'll also see them noted to you in your teacher dashboard. And then of course that measurable impact through our impact reports, we are working on finalizing those right now with a plan to roll them out the final week of June. So if you are with any district office, be on the lookout for that. But if you are at a school site and you're interested in seeing your district impact report, simply let us know and we can absolutely provide that as well. So moving forward, really the next steps is to be thinking about placement of the different programs. Where do you see this working at your school site, at your district site? This is where we can really work alongside you to incorporate the lessons into your curriculum guide, your scope and sequence, so that you can really see that placement and standards alignment. That's what Andy and I are here for. We're happy to help support that. We wanna make this as low lift for you as possible. And then the next piece is setting up training. So whether you are wanting to set up trainings for your staff departments, so the social studies staff, your counselors, whatever that might look like, we can provide site-based, so working at one individual school, or we can provide it for district-wide. Really depends on the needs of your district and how you see rolling this out for your schools. And then we also have resources available in Canvas. We offer single sign-on through Clever and soon to be ClassLink. So we're happy to work with you to think about single sign-on, as we know that's going to just make things a lot easier for your students, your teachers to gain access. And then finally, of course, we'll be providing updates on usage that you can share back with your community and have available for your schools. Because I believe a few of us here on the call today are educators, I do wanna chat in step-by-step instructions on how to register. So let's see if it'll let me. If you visit everfi.com/new-teacher, here is where you can register for your own teacher account. And I'll go ahead and take us there as well. So if you want to visit everfi.com/new-teacher, do need to log out. You're going to hit register. And from here, you're going to have the opportunity to select teacher, choose your state, and then begin typing in your school name. There's a short form to fill out from here with your first name, last name, school or district email address, and password. Then you'll hit a button that says, I agree to the terms of service. And then you'll have full access to our teacher dashboard. Give everyone a minute. I know we have a few of us still on here. Once you've registered, the first step that you'll want to do, and let's see, since I logged out, the first step you'll want to do is head to the catalog. And within the catalog, this is where you're going to see, I was waiting for that. This is where you're going to see all of the course resources that Andy shared with us today. So in here is where you can add those money moves, you can add FutureSmart, Vault, EVERFI, and if you have questions specific to your school or your class or your district, please let Andy and I know. That's certainly where the two of us can help with placement, but simply click add and you'll have access to that on your dashboard. Again, it was catalog, and then looking in the financial education suite, which is listed up top, you can simply hit add in that green button and it'll be added to your teacher dashboard. I'm going to pause now and just leave time for some questions, discussion. This is your opportunity. Thank you for carving time out on your Tuesday afternoons. If you have specific questions for your school, your class, your district, we're here to help answer those and talk through how we might be able to best support you.
And please, you can either put in the chat or you can unmute yourself. Because we have a small group, we knew we were going to have an informal group.
So, thank you. This is amazing resources, and I work at a middle school, so excited to see your middle school program. So I am in the process of trying to log in, and I keep getting an error message.
Deborah, what district are you at?
Desert Sands Unified.
All right, so we just work with Desert Sands, so you are gonna access through Clever. So whenever you visit everfi.com/login.
Okay, so right now the district's Clever is down. That's probably.
That might be
you
it.
Mine has popped up. It didn't pop up before. Okay, so I'm in Clever.
Okay. So if you can either go to everfi.com, log in, and select log in with Clever. And then you would put in your credentials and I'll take you that way. But if you're in your Clever dashboard, look for the EVERFI app.
It should be among all of your apps. So it's an E for EVERFI, and I believe it's mostly orange.
All righty. Well, I do not see it.
Let me see if I can. Find an image of it so that it makes it a little easier. Okay. So let me. It's slowly loading, Deborah, but I do. We worked with a few folks in Desert Sands. I think.
Right. No. Interestingly enough, it is not on ours. So I'm wondering, is it not on Palm Desert Charter Middle Schools? Did we somehow, sometimes they leave us off because we're a dependent charter.
Does it? What?
So Katie Eklund, you know, maybe has not given us access because I did try to go in that way too.
Great. Let me, we can send a note to her and I'll check in my system too. And then we can follow up with you, Deborah, and make sure that you're all set.
Absolutely, because you have a lot of wonderful resources there to explore that, you know, are ideally suited for middle school. And, you know, I also really like their short. They seem to be standalone as well. Is that correct? I mean, the opportunity for, you know, a teacher to, you know, if a student has some extra time that they might be able to go in and kids can go at their own pace. I also really like that they're based on reading level, not necessarily, you know, the information is elementary, but because, you know, we have our students that, you know, this might be something that would get them more excited about reading, who are low readers, and what a, you know, nice kind of, you know, extra, you know, reward maybe that they would get to do. This kind of, it's still reading, it's teaching great content, but, you know, something for them to add to their class. I mean, I could see it being used a lot of different ways. I just had no idea that you had these resources available.
Yeah, you touched on a lot of great points. And one of them is that it is self-paced for students. And so we do have some teachers who use it completely independently for students where they sign on and just go through it at their own pace. But we also have offline lesson plans for every course that you add. So let's say that after some students have finished certain modules, if the teacher wants to do a whole group lesson plan, they could do that with one of the offline lessons or discussion guides. But those are just some different resources that help make it supplemental. And it really is meant to support what you're already teaching in your classroom.
Right. Well, I love it. I'm almost thinking I need to completely reboot because when I go in through that login, it's telling me this page isn't working. So I either have to wait until Katie Eklund puts it on through Clever for us and you know, something I would like all of our teachers to be able to access, or I need to reboot because it said that it took in my password and apparently I already had an account. I don't know if that's because I registered here or not.
We will get to the bottom of it. So you will have access. Don't worry about that.
All right.
I'm checking on the back end now, and then what I'll do is I'll send you an email, and if we need a loop in Katie to have your school included, I'll copy you in and make sure you're all set.
Fantastic. Well, thank you, ladies. I appreciate it, and thank you for sharing this resource with me.
Thanks for coming.
It's very interesting.
Good.
Bye-bye.
Anyone else have any questions or anything you want to speak about specific to your school or district?
I'm sorry if I missed this. Is this free for Riverside County?
It's free for everyone. So all of our resources are funded by local and national partners. So we're constantly updating them, making them relevant, keeping them up to speed with new standards and content. But these national and local partners are paying for it, so you all can use it at no cost. So unlimited student licenses for your school and your district.
Awesome, thank you. How would you recommend promoting it to teachers who might not be on board?
Yeah, oftentimes we think the best practice is to have, if there is an opportunity to have a training, we find that once teachers see it and can get in there, take a look at it, usually they're buying when they see this is really low lift. In a 40 minute training, I can have everything set up and ready to go for my class for the whole year. So we really recommend if there's an opportunity to set up some kind of training, that can be the most impactful because then it really creates those, gets rid of those barriers to entry, helps to see what the ease of implementation can look like. But also Andy is available to help do, you know, whether that's a site training, we can also pull together any kind of resources too that you think would be helpful, whether it's showing some kind of alignment or otherwise, but whatever you feel is best, we're happy to have that conversation one-to-one with you as well.
Thank you so much.
So Jessica, when you say it's free, so for example, if I'm a, you know, a school site administrator, I want to bring it in, but I maybe need Andy to do three different meetings with three different departments, that's free too. Like, I want them to understand, like, it's not just the platform's free, but then you got to pay for the coach or the service. Can you just confirm that as well?
Yeah, everything's free. So anything you're doing, working with EVERFI for our K-12 student-facing resources, it's going to be at no cost. So Andy is our local support. She's able to provide ongoing trainings, answer tech questions, support teachers with implementation. That is what we're here for. All of our services that Andy and I are providing to our districts, our schools, our teachers are at no cost. So that includes our full digital library, all of the supplemental lesson plans, and then the support from our EVERFI team. So there will never be a time where you will receive any kind of invoice or bill from the EVERFI team for implementing these programs. So free. Better than free, really, is what we like to call them, because you're getting all these added bonuses and support from us.
Okay. Another idea that's come up is working with you. If I, let's say I'm a school counselor and I want to get started, working with you to help me build a parent night or a parent event or a student event, and you're willing to help with that as well, correct?
Yeah, absolutely. So we're happy, our resources right now, we do have a direct to family portal. So we're happy to show that. We can also build in, if you wanna be sure to get that data and usage, we can also walk through how to create a school-wide cohort. So then when students log in and work on this independently, you all can still see those students that are going in, get their data, be able to see the completion. So we're happy to work with you all for family nights, whether it's for college or career readiness, maybe it's just talking about, hey, we're laying the foundation for financial literacy, come join us. We're happy to work with you on those too.
If we can be part of it.
Hi, it's Sally Fraser. I'm with Debbie Dolan at Palm Desert Charter Middle. We had a question about the longitudinal study and if we could participate.
Yeah, of course. So I will re-chat in this link with more data. If you have families that you think are interested in being a part of this, absolutely please share this with them. We can also, as mentioned, pull in that aggregate data from those families in your district to be able to highlight, okay, what are the changes we're seeing year over year, and be able to give you that more data to say, okay, financial literacy is making an impact in our community. So I did share that link with you. Feel free to share directly with your families. Okay. We're happy to talk about it more in more detail too, if you'd like.
I'm curious about, it said, when I quickly looked at it, it said that the students who are in that longitudinal study are obviously going to go through your full literacy suite. Who is going to be responsible for teaching that suite? So let's say, a parent signs up. Is the expectation that we at our school site are going to have all of that literacy available here, or is it going to be done through, the family's going to do it together at home? How does that work?
Yeah, that's, you kind of nailed it, Sally. So ideally we are working with districts that are using this in the classroom, but for this study, we will have our team that is working directly with these families to implement these resources at home. Each year they'll get access, in seventh and eighth grade, they'll be going through our Future Smart course. And then each year we will level them up based on these other programs available. So the idea is that these programs, if students are participating in this study, they are doing this at home with their families. It's not a requirement for the school or district to be doing it. But we find our plan is to really do, as this is going on, identify the students that are also doing this in school to see if there's a difference between those that are just doing at home versus those that are doing at school and at home.
And there is, did I read it correctly? They will be paid $500 a year for each year they participate.
Yes.
And possibly $600 the second year, $700 the year after that. It even implied that as well. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's correct. So if this is something that you all are really interested in for your school, or that families would be very interested in this, we can pull together a presentation specifically for Palm Desert Charter. And then we can even have Dr. Dan, he's our main research, or Samantha Church join to share more details about the study if this is something you wanna share out with your community in more detail.
So at what time, I didn't notice, was there an expiration date? Is this something we could share in August, or is it something that we need to share this June?
That is a fantastic question that I don't have the answer to. I am going to ask when the cutoff is for this, and I'll get back to you.
All right,
great.
We're happy to share it with our families.
That would be fantastic.
Is it only offered for seventh and eighth grade families, or do we have a high school option as well?
Right now it is for seventh and eighth grade families, as we want to be able to measure longitudinal as they're going through high school, so for at least 4 years. So that's why we're really starting it at that middle school level.
Thank you.
Well, I think that's a wonderful opportunity for
our kids. I do too. Sounds really great.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
We're really excited to kick it off. It's the first we've ever done like this. So we're happy to hear the excitement and interest in this. So I'll get you more details so that you can share with your families, and I'll figure out when that cutoff deadline is too.
Okay, that's awesome. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you.
I heard that you were available to help with PLCs and introducing these programs and supporting teachers. Is that true in just the financial literacy courses, or is that also true in the science, your STEM class, and the other? I think you had someone that were SEL as well.
We're happy to, go ahead, Andy.
Yep, so all of those programs are free, and you're right. There were a ton of different verticals that we went over. Was I interrupting someone? I couldn't tell. Was there another question coming in?
Do you want to ask another?
I was just curious if there was support for the SEL lessons that you had as well.
Yes. So I am the schools manager for all things EVERFI. So if you have questions about the financial literacy program, STEM preparedness, social emotional learning, in that slide that we called the menu that showed all the different verticals we cover, I'm more than happy to support you in usage for all of those programs, whether it be, you emailing me with questions or requesting a teacher training, In some cases, I even meet with students right now via Zoom, but if you want me to virtually visit your classroom and walk them through registration. So yes, I am the person that supports you for all of these verticals that you see up here, all the colored tiles up there. So financial education, STEM and career readiness, SEL, health and wellness, early academic readiness, and then diversity, equity, and inclusion.
So I see some of those under health and wellness are ideal for, you know, middle school and mm-hmm. you know, definitely some areas that we have to address.
Certainly. Yeah. And today's presentation really was geared towards financial literacy. Those were the courses that we spent the majority of the time focused on, but you see this menu here, that's everything else. And you have access to all of that.
And Andy, I think Sally, or maybe it was Deborah had asked, we can support with those PLC meetings too. So if there is a group that specifically focuses on health and wellness or social emotional learning, Andy can host a training specific to that group as well.
You know, did you share this, is this particular menu on your website?
So not in the same beautiful format, but I do know that Jamina will be sharing this, and Riverside County will be sharing this presentation with you all following today. But let me go ahead and show you where you can see all of our resources on our website. So if you go to everfi.com/K-12.
All right.
And then here, if you scroll down, you can explore the resources, and it breaks it down into financial education, social emotional learning, health wellness, college career, and early learning. So you can pick which one you want, and then it breaks it down into elementary, middle, and high school for each of those pages. So if you scroll down, my computer is going very slowly, but here you can see, if I select middle school, you can see the programs that include SEL for middle school students.
Gotcha.
Yeah, so we're happy to continue this conversation too, if you want to set up another call to talk through exactly what you all need at Palm Desert Charter. We're happy to think through the placement of the programs and how to support you all.
And you will be receiving, as Jamina just mentioned, the recording of this session and the PowerPoint via email. So you'll be able to access all this information too at a later time, but you can obviously email us, call me if you need anything as well.
Oh, great. Thank you so much. We appreciate it.
Yes, thank you.
You bet.
And I'm gonna put Andy and his contact information again, so that you all have that. Feel free to email us. We're happy to help support and answer your questions and set up trainings, whatever you might need.
Oh, that would be great. Thank you so much. We'll be in touch.
No, awesome. Thank you. And this is why, you know, we know it's the timing is, you know, we're closing out the year. We've closed out the year, but we want to make sure no one's reinventing the wheel and that we know what's available. So I just thank you, Andy and Jessica, for doing this for us. And like Jamina said in the chat, we'll send out a copy of the PowerPoint along with the recording. And then there'll be plenty of other sessions. But Jessica and Andy they're willing to work and even with one school site, one counselor. They've been awesome with this partnership. And the $500 thing was super amazing. We got to definitely get the word out on that.
Yeah.
So, okay. All right. Final thoughts, Jessica or Andy, before we close out?
No, just thank you all for your time today. And we're so excited to work with Riverside County on this initiative. And anything you might need, don't hesitate to reach out. We're here to help.
Thank you all for coming. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Have a great day.